Nothing like getting ready for the most popular podcast in all of Central Minnesota. But the brethren depend upon it. The brothers and sisters in Christ enjoy a little encouragement. All of us enjoy a little encouragement. So go pour yourself a cup of coffee. You know when this comes on, it's about 30 seconds away. What a beautiful day in Central Minnesota. Beautiful indeed. I'm gonna walk into the studio right now. Won't you join us all on today's episode of the Critical Christian Crowd? My name's Lon Linke. See you in a bit. Good morning, saints. Welcome, sinners. It is a beautiful day in Central Minnesota. It's a little dark in the old box this morning. There's a reason for that. We're live streaming on Facebook. If you haven't friended me yet, feel free to do so on Facebook. Or slip on over to the 5 days we have left in YouTube. And that's the topic of the morning. The great December 10th YouTube purge. And we do have an exciting program for you here this morning. Of course, let's do a quick Bible lesson. Make sure you know who you are. My little software icon is blocking that first one. You got to know who you are, folks. You got to know that if you trust in the Lord and realize that the kingdom of God is at hand, all things will be added. And that's the way it is. And there is great peace with that. There's great reward, freedom, liberty in the name of Jesus Christ. And it's just that simple. I wish it was more complicated, but it is not. Let's get right to the point here. I was up late last night. Everybody in the FE community, in the biblical cosmology community, knows who Vincent Rhodes is. I believe he'll be attending the Biblical Earther Conference down in Helen, Georgia next April. But he was on a rant last night about the YouTube thing, and I slipped over to KJ on the scariest movie ever. He as well was just going off, and of course everyone's very concerned about what's happening. I thought I was going to, you know, I'd be able to just come on and explain it myself, but then I watched a YouTube posting from Red Pill Philosophy, and it was really, really great. So I'm going to give credit where due credit is, or credit is due, and let's get right to it. This is Red Pill Philosophy, and he's going to do the commentary, and it's the best commentary I've heard yet on this this purge that's coming, the community standards that are going to be changed, wholesale change, and those of us who are white, heterosexual, Christian men believe that that purge is going to be targeted directly at us. And, of course, all the knuckleheads will get to stay on and do their nonsense because they are the children of the dark side, and Satan is their daddy. But anyway, enough of me. Let's get right to Red Pill Philosophy, shall we? Okie dokie. Sit back, relax, enjoy. This is the Imperishable Wreath.
And that has been my number one priority. We're removing content that violates our policies. We removed, just in the last quarter, 9 million videos.
You recently 9 million videos in the last quarter. In 3 months, they removed 9 million videos.
Susan Wojcicki, the worst CEO of Silicon Valley in the history of big tech, was interviewed by 60 Minutes last night. And I'm hearing it's a pretty big train wreck, given all the hype about the December 10th purge of mass deleting channels, commercially viable, all that stuff, COPPA, given the election of 2020 is coming up right around the corner. A lot of factors are coming in right now. Things are about to get really crazy. So let's see what Susan Wojcicki has to say to the fake news mainstream media.
To grasp the phenomenal scale of YouTube, consider that people spend 1 billion hours watching videos on it every day. It's the most used social network in the U.S. More queries are typed into the website search bar than anywhere online except Google, which owns you.
And this old hag hates it. She hates that her dying mainstream media empire got superseded by a whole new revolution.
YouTube. But the site has come under increasing scrutiny, accused of propagating white supremacy, peddling conspiracies, and profiting from it all.
Meanwhile, the biggest conspiracy in the world is literally the Russia hoax that Donald Trump is Putin's son and they infiltrated the White House. And Putin, the Kremlin, currently runs the White House. Oh my God, but...
They recently agreed to pay a record $170 million to settle allegations that they targeted children with ads.
Yeah, like the mainstream media doesn't target children. Just, oh God.
YouTube is being forced to concentrate on cleansing the site. We visited the company's headquarters in San Bruno, California, to meet Susan Wojcicki, the 51-year-old CEO in charge of nurturing the site's creativity, taming the hate, and handling the chaos.
The story will continue in a moment.
Most people don't know
that. Wow, another massive ad. Every commercial is just, it's all about healthcare and antidepressants on television. It's ridiculous. But yeah, I love how the fake news mainstream media gets all these big corporate sponsors. But we YouTube content creators, the people who are literally pioneering the modern renaissance, the creative renaissance that's taking place on the internet, all we get are a few pennies. Incredible. Let's skip this ad.
When democratic policies fail, you're racist, they keep saying it. It's the last refuge of the discredited Democrat politician.
As long as you support the narrative, doesn't matter what you're saying. You can be out there saying that men can be women and that grown-ass men should share the freaking public bathroom with your 5-year-old daughter, and you're going to get a bunch of ads running on your mainstream media channel. But if you're a YouTube content creator and you say the earth is flat, because all science confirms that, then you get demonetized and deboosted. Let's see what Susan Wojcicki, who looks like she's aging really badly nowadays, has to say, because she loves to talk about how much she's a champion for free speech and how important it is, and it's what made YouTube what it is. But we have the upcoming December 10th purge, potential purge. We have the commercially viable thing, which I have a different take on than most people. But we have the COPPA thing, which is a massive destruction. Let's watch.
We have 500 hours of video uploaded every single minute to YouTube.
Say that again.
So we have...
The 60 Minutes reporter, she just, like, she giggled, but she just sounded so bitter and butthurt because they can only pump out 24 hours of content a day on their stupid CBS 60 Minutes or whatever channel this shit airs on. That's right. 500 hours of real people uploading real content on their phones. I know. It's hard to compete with that, ain't it?
There's a children's channel with over 44 billion views.
Do you let your children watch YouTube, including the young ones?
So I allow my younger kids to use YouTube Kids, but I limit the amount of time that they're on it. I think too much of anything is not a good thing, but there's a lot you can learn on YouTube. I think about how YouTube in many ways is this global library. You want to see any historical speech? You could see it. You want to be able to...
That old hag, Sissy Minutes reporter, is so butthurt. She's like, you know, back in the day, you had to flip the TV on and watch my fucking face to see anything. Oh, they're so pathetic.
Learn a language.
Make a souffle. Different.
You want to laugh. You just want to see something funny. You want to do a souffle. Oh, yeah, cooking. Cooking's a great example.
Who's watching people binge eat?
With the subject Ukraine.
A growing number of American adults are turning to it for their news, sports, medical information. It's now mankind's largest how-to collection.
Take the thick end,
how to tie a tie, tie the knot, or speak tie. The site has produced whole new pastimes where millions watch strangers open boxes.
Hold your phone like that.
Whisper. Sleep. YouTube's artificial intelligence algorithms keep recommending new videos, so users watch more and more and more.
Happy Friday?
Yeah, the algorithm is smart. Oh, the algorithm is effective. The algorithm is something you, the TV mafia, can't compete with.
Hey.
Wojcicki invited us to the weekly all-staff meeting. She's surprisingly down to earth.
Weekly all-staff meeting. Oh my God, this is where they decide. Not even that. They don't even decide how to censor reality in public forums, a meeting like this. This is all backdoor stuff, I'm sure.
One of the most powerful people in...
Imagine a weekly meeting on how to destroy YouTube. Because that's all that's happened under Susan Wojcicki's watch. It has imploded, and it's embarrassing.
Silicon Valley.
And of course, we had to have fun.
Where her trajectory really started in an unlikely way.
I owned a garage, and I was worried about covering the mortgage. So I was willing to rent my garage to any student. But then two students appeared. One was named Sergey Brin. The other was named Larry Page. They are the founders of Google.
Yes, they are.
But at the time, they were just students. They looked like any other students.
Larry and Sergey ended up hiring her as their first marketing manager. She was Google employee 16. As the company grew, so did her role, and so did her family. She has five children.
God, here we go with the... I'm a CEO and I'm a mother, and I just think it's so great that we can have, like, five kids and still run, like, the biggest internet platform out there. Like, yeah, woman power, yeah. It's like, Susan, bro, like... The amount of people that just don't like you as a CEO is crazy, dude. You're one of the most disliked CEOs in the history of, like, CEOs. It's that bad. Like, just please. There's just no hope, dude. There's just no hope.
Google bought YouTube on her recommendation for over $1.6 billion, and 8 years later, she became CEO with a mandate to make it grow and make it profitable.
Disgusting. Google bought YouTube under her recommendation, but at the same time, she is... really not championing the values that made YouTube what it is today. It's almost ridiculous how much of a fail it's been.
And she did. Its estimated worth is $160 billion.
Find your solution at ShopViews.
YouTube makes most of its money from ads.
Hello, let's do this.
Splitting revenue with people who create all kinds of videos.
Instead of acrylic paint, you're going to be using enamel paint.
From do-it-yourself lessons...
Then it goes, ta-ta-ta.
So ...to hip-hop lessons.
Clicking here.
The more popular ones can become multi-million dollar entrepreneurs.
Joe Biden promised you...
And you don't like that, do you, you old witch?
...Ukraine $1 billion if they fire the prosecutor investigating his son's company.
YouTube also makes money from political ads, a thorny issue because some of them have been used to spread lies on social media.
Facebook is facing a lot of controversy because it refuses to take down a President Trump ad about Biden, which is not true. Would you run that ad?
So that is an ad that right now would not be a violation of our policies.
Is it on YouTube right now?
It has been on YouTube.
Can a politician lie on YouTube?
For every single video, I think it's really important to look at it. Politicians are always accusing their opponents of lying. That said, it's not...
She don't want to hear that, though. Only Trump is a liar. Speaking of which, guys... Trump 2020, finally someone with balls. These amazing t-shirts are available for the upcoming 2020 election. Trump hasn't really done jack shit when it comes to internet big tech censorship. It's actually just pathetic. I'm getting to the point now where I'm starting to realize I don't think Trump's going to do shit about it. There's still a chance he might, but I don't think he's going to do anything. So we just need to find another platform. YouTube is a lost cause. But I'm still holding out a little bit of hope. And if you are still two guys, Trump 2020 finally summoned with balls. These incredible T-shirts are now available. Just click the link right down there below and you can pick one up for yourself. Let's get back in to this ridiculous video.
Not okay to have technically manipulated content that would be misleading. For example, there was a video uploaded of Nancy Pelosi. It was slowed down just enough that it was unclear whether or not she was in her full capacity because she was speaking in a slower voice.
Why would I work with you if you're investigating me?
But the title of the video actually said drunk, had that in the title. And we removed that video.
How fast did you remove it?
Very fast.
But not completely. We just did a search, and there it was, still available.
Look at this old hag on a laptop. She looks like such a goofball.
Why would I work with you if you're investigating me?
Look at this.
The title of the video actually said drunk, had that in the title. And we removed that video.
How fast did you remove it?
Very fast.
Look at this old hag dinosaur on a laptop. She looks so goofy. This is the face of everyone that wants the internet shut down right here. This is the portrait right here of every single dinosaur that wants the internet shut down, friends. This is it right here. An old freaking hag like with big glasses trying to use her fucking Apple laptop. It's all over, guys.
But not completely. We just did a search, and there it was, still available. The company keeps trying to erase the purported name of the impeachment whistleblower, but that, too, is still there.
Just shut down everything. Just shut all communication highways. Just shut them all down. Because we don't like that you can Google things for yourself.
Which raises doubts about their system's ability to cleanse the site. In the 2016 election cycle, YouTube failed to detect Russian trolls
Are these the 10,000 random fucking retards they hired to arbitrate what videos are hate speech and what videos aren't? What an embarrassing humiliation to the fucking internet. Yeah, let's just, hey guys, why don't we just get rid of cars, automobiles, and go back to the horse and carriage? Because, you know, I don't think the horse and buggy industry was really happy that cars were invented and basically made them obsolete. Guys, let's go back to the horse and buggies, okay? Because the horse and buggy people, they don't like innovation and they don't like technology.
In the 2016 election cycle.
Well, my sincere thanks to Red Pill Philosophy. He did a great, great job today. And I think that message that he had posted went up maybe a couple of days ago. But it really was good, and it was worth the repost. And now I can get some Minnesota sunlight in here. Good morning. So, anyway, I wanted to thank you for taking the time. I thought it was worth the effort. And, of course, the YouTube purge is now just 5 days away. Until that time, you can get over to Fisherman in a Box and view this. I'm still testing things out, but we're getting pretty close to dress rehearsal. Matter of fact, I might even want to call this one a dress rehearsal today. I didn't think it was too bad. I'd love to hear your comments, both on Facebook and YouTube as well. I'm waiting on that studio equipment. Obviously, you can tell the audio and the jib cameras need to be. I need a lot of work there, a lot of work. Oh, and one more thing as well. As I continue on, and I'm not afraid of anybody. I'm not afraid of any, the most powerful CEO in America or on God's static breadth realm. I'm not afraid. So while everyone else is worried about their YouTube channels, I'm building one, okay? So what I said at the beginning, you got to know who you are. You got to know that the kingdom of God is at hand. You got to trust him. And if you do, all things will be added. Most of all, you got to calm down, Christian. You got to calm down. But we do have to start standing up, speaking up, no anger. But if we don't stand up and speak up right now, we've got less than 11 months till the next presidential election. And like I've said before, I think America will be on fire before that day comes. If we make it to the 1st of November and it's not on fire, the day before the election, the day of the election, or the day after the election, it will be on fire. And that is a little prophecy from your stinky old fisherman in a box. One last point of housekeeping here that I wanted to take care of. I'm looking for guests to come on the program. My camera, this is a free trial service I had on this particular software, and very shortly that will run out, and I'll become a paid subscriber. And as a paid subscriber, I get all sorts of cool and groovy options. The only thing I'm missing are the audio improvements. So I am looking for guests. If you do want to come on either live or do a tape show, that'd be fine too. I can promise you this. I got all my technical stuff in line. Ain't no Johnny Bananas you're dealing with here. You're dealing with the old guy who baits his own hook, the fisherman in a box. And I guarantee it'll be fun. So if you've got a podcast you want to promote, you want a channel you want to promote, if you're still alive after the great YouTube purge, you got a book you'd like to promote, give me a jingle. Let me know. I'd love to have you on. God bless y'all. Thank you very much. I'm going to close things out here today with a photograph I took off of the balcony. Got a little God's glory in it as well. God bless y'all.